Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So in our previous video, we have started our new lesson, that is what? Microorganisms, friend and foe. Okay, so in that already we have discussed some points, we have started our point, that is what? Five major groups of a microorganisms. Okay, in that already we have discussed about the bacteria and viruses. So today we will move for the next group of a microorganism, that is nothing but what? Algae. Okay, so let's discuss about the algae. They are simple plant like organisms containing chlorophyll. Okay, so the algae are simple plant like organisms containing chlorophyll. Very important characteristics about the algae is that what? They are the plant like organism and they also contain the chlorophyll like a plants. Okay, but the very important thing is that what? They not have, or they do not have the leaves, stem or the other plant organ which are the normally plants are having. Okay, so the algae are plant like organism containing chlorophyll, but they not have any plant organs like stem, root, leaves or the branches. Okay, only the thing is that they are having the chlorophyll, and that is the reason they can make their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process. Okay, so the algae can make their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process because they are having the chlorophyll in them. Okay, now the next point is that they are eukaryotic in nature. Now eukaryotic in the nature means what? They are having the well developed or well organized nucleus with a nuclear membrane. Okay, so the algae are eukaryotic in nature. Well developed, well organized nucleus is present in the cell. Okay, we'll move for the next point, that is algae in Latin means seaweeds. Okay, so algae, what is the meaning of the algae in the Latin? That is nothing but what? Seaweeds. Okay, next one is that they are unicellular and multicellular. Okay, so some algae are unicellular, so they are so much tiny, to observe them we have to use the microscope, or we can say that there are the some algae which are multicellular, which are so much long, or we can say that it comes their lengths we can count within a meter also. Okay, so in this way what we can say that some algae are unicellular and some algae are multicellular. Okay, and the examples of the algae are what? Seaweeds and Spirogyra. Okay, so all this is about what? Algae. They are simple plant like organism containing chlorophyll. They can make their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process. Also they are eukaryotic in nature. Also algae means what? In the Latin word algae means what? Seaweed. Okay, and the next one is what? It can be unicellular, or the some algae are multicellular also. Okay, so this is about what? Algae. This is the third major group of microorganism. Now we'll move for the next group of a microorganism, that is what? Fungi. Okay, so let's discuss about the fungi. A group of diverse animal organisms that lack chlorophyll. Very important thing about the fungi is what? It is a group of an organism, or the diverse organism. Diverse means what? There is a variety of the fungi are present on the earth, but the very important thing is what? Which lack chlorophyll. Okay, means what? There is a absence of chlorophyll in the fungi. Okay, a group of diverse organism that lack chlorophyll. Fungi doesn't contain the chlorophyll. Okay, next one is that they are found in the moist and humid places. Mostly the fungi can grow into the warm and the humid and the dark area. Okay, they can found in the moist and the humid places or in the dark places. So as we know, the spores of the fungi is already present in the air. Whenever that spores are getting the favorable condition, it started to grow on any surface, and mostly we can see during the rainy season. Why? Because in the rainy season there is a favorable condition for the spores of the fungi. There is a hot and humid climatic condition is there, and that is the reason most of the places or the most of the fungi grows in the rainy season. season. Okay, so this is what they are found in the moist and the humid places, or also in the dark places. Okay, next one, it may be unicellular like yeast, or it may be multicellular like mushroom. Okay, so like algae, fungi also. Okay, the fungi can be also unicellular or it can be multicellular also. So the example of the unicellular fungi is what? Yeast. And the example of the multicellular fungi is what? Mushroom. Okay, so in this way it may be unicellular or multicellular. Fungi is also eukaryotic in nature. Eukaryotic in nature means what? They are also having the well developed or the well organized nucleus with a well nuclear membrane. Okay, next one, examples of the fungi. Now we will see that, that is what? Mold or mucor, we can say that, and penicillium. Okay, so this is all about what? Fungi. Okay, next one, or the next group of a microorganism we will discuss, that is nothing but what? Protozoa. Okay, so let's discuss about the last major group of a microorganism, that is what? Protozoa. So what is mean by protozoa? Okay, the protozoa means what? First animal. Okay, protozoa means what? First animal, and they are included in a separate kingdom, that is what? Protista. Okay, they included in a separate kingdom, that is protista. Okay, so protozoan means what? First animal. They are mainly aquatic, very important. So the protozoas are mainly aquatic, that is they found in the pond, lake, river, okay, or any humid other damp soil. Okay, so they are mainly aquatic, found in the pond, lake, river, okay, or the damp soil also. Next one is that they are also eukaryotic in the nature. Next one, they are either saprophytic or parasitic. Okay, so the protozoas are either saprophytic or parasitic. Okay, so these two types of the nutrients that you have already seen in your previous classes. Okay, saprophytic means what? They are leaving certain types of the digestive enzymes on that, and again in that digestive enzymes the food get mixed and again they suck that. Okay, parasitic means what? They are depends on the other for their food. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that what? Protozoas are saprophytic or parasitic. Next one is that exception. There is an exception for this condition, or there is an exception for this characteristic, that is what? Euglena. Okay, why the euglena is exception? Because the euglena contain the chlorophyll, and that is the reason they can make their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process. Okay, so euglena is an exception for these characteristic, that is what? They are either saprophytic or parasitic, but the euglena is autotrophic, we can say. Why? Because they can make their own food because of the presence of chlorophyll in them. Okay, and the last point, that is what? Examples of the protozoa, that are what? Amoeba and paramecium. Okay, so all these are the examples of protozoa. Okay, so here we have discussed the different major groups of a microorganism. We have discussed about the algae, fungi and protozoa. Algae means what? The simple plant like organism containing chlorophyll. Okay, and they are vary in their shape, size and the habitat also. They are eukaryotic nature. Algae means what? Seaweed. They are unicellular or multicellular. While fungi, they lack the chlorophyll, they are also eukaryotic in nature. Okay, they are found in the moist and the humid places, they are also unicellular or multicellular. And the last one is that protozoa means what? First animal. They are also eukaryotic in nature, mainly found in the aquatic region, and they are either saprophytic or parasitic, but the exception is what? Euglena. Okay, so this is all about today. It is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.